So the typical autofill function in Safari would allow you to fill in IDs and passwords to websites when you want to log into them. For instance, here at Twitter, I can click on the login fields here and I can select from multiple logins I've got and log on with that. But that's only one of many functions. If we go into Safari Preferences and go to Autofill, we could see that you have four different types of autofill. And the one I want to talk about right now is using info from my contacts. So how does that work? Well, that works in a situation where you're not logging into a site, but you're still asked to enter something like your email address or your name. Now a really good example is the MacMost website itself. I don't have user accounts at MacMost. Anybody can leave a comment. But when you do leave a comment, I ask that you fill in your name and email. And this is useful when I want to respond to you directly. Maybe if your comment is off topic, or I feel it's better if I just email you back as a response rather than responding here. So I ask you for your name and email, and the email is not included on the site and your name is put there with the comment. Now these can be autofilled as well, and the way it works in Safari is really easy. If you click to type into the field here, you get this little person icon, and you click on it, you get a menu where you can select a name. And the same thing here for email. You click and you see you can select an email address. And you can also hit this thing where it says autofill. And what autofill does is it fills in both of these fields. Whereas if I were to select, say, an email address here, it would fill in this email field but not fill in the name field. So you have ways to quickly autofill your name and your email address without having to type the entire thing from scratch. So where does it get this information from? Well, you may have noticed that under Preferences, Autofill, there's this Edit button. This Edit button will actually open up the Contacts app and take you directly to your card in the Contacts app. If you're using Contacts, or even if you're not, you're going to have a card here that is your card. And you can alter it. If it's on the wrong one under Card, you can say, make this my card. You can see this is already my card here. And this is your identification information. So there's my name, and there are my email addresses. Now this only works if you have at least one email address filled in. So you can see I've got two email addresses here, both using the same name. And that's what we saw there. There was a home and work. I can add more email addresses. And hit Done here. And of course, if I'm coming into this from Contacts, I would see it here and I would hit Edit to actually edit it. But that Edit button actually takes me directly there. Now when I go to fill out this field here, you can see there's that new one. It appears, so I can enter that in. And you can see I still just have these two here, Home and Work. I'm not sure if I hit the Customize button here, I can actually go and I can see all three of these and select the one I want. There we go. So you have these options, and it's really handy to not have to type your entire name or type your email address every time you are asked for them on the web, even if it's not something where you're logging in.